Well, hello there, ladies and gentlemen, boys and girls. Muzzafuzza here, back on the mic once again, doing some more Modern Warfare 3 gameplay commentary. And today, I'm bringing you guys a little drop zone on bootleg Modern Warfare 3, kicking it like it's still 2011. I think this game came out in late 2011. It always comes out in November, and it is just about done with its cycle as I'm doing this commentary. Black Ops 2 is right around the corner. Everybody's kicking it, just kind of relaxing and hopefully not playing Modern Warfare 3 as much. I don't know, let me know in the comments below if you guys are still playing this game, but I think for the most part, pretty much all of my YouTube friends have not touched this game in like either months or weeks. It's just been sort of dead. Nobody really is feeling it anymore. But like I said, Blue Tiger, Model 1887 gameplay, shotgunning people in the face. Enjoy that. But what I want to bring you guys today is another one of those really long commentaries where I ramble on and get into random banter and story time about one certain thing today, role models. I thought I would talk about role models since this is a model gameplay. I thought I would talk about role models, not to be confused with supermodels. Supermodels are a totally different breed, and I've actually seen quite a few around now that I'm living in Los Angeles. Like, if we ever go to Beverly Hills or Hollywood, you're bound to see either a really pretty actress or a supermodel or some sort of lingerie model or a porn star even. You'll see all sorts of crazy stuff like that all around Los Angeles. And before I get into this commentary, I do want to tell you guys a random story from today, because this actually just happened like a few hours ago. We got in a little car accident. We got in a little car wreck. Me and my buddy were driving back from this mall, and we were headbanging to some Skrillex. We were playing dubstep really loud and driving at the same time, which is not a good idea. Not quite as dangerous as maybe texting and driving or talking on the phone and driving at the same time, but we were definitely dancing way too hard in the car, and we ran into the back of a Mitsubishi Eclipse, and this foreign guy jumps out of the car and he's like, "Hey, what the hell, man?" And we had to kind of talk him down, and he was cool after a while, but we definitely tapped the back of his vehicle. And it wasn't even that we were accelerating, like we didn't like run into him. We just, he was headbanging and he took his foot off the brake, so we let off the brake and we just kind of rolled into him. So it was like a slight little tap-tap and scratched up the back of his car, so we had to give him our insurance and stuff. It was horrible. Don't get in car accidents. It's never any fun. Car accidents are no bueno. But to get into the meat and potatoes of today's commentary, let's talk about role models. Who are my role models? Who are your guys' role models? I think it's kind of a weird way to look at the world. If you look at it in like a idealistic, idolized way, where you look at one specific person, you're like, yeah, I want to be like this guy. I want to be like Michael Jordan, or I want to be like Drake, or I want to be like Lil Wayne, or whatever it is, whatever you see people conforming to. I think role models are still a really solid idea, and it's kind of a good foundation to have people that you look up to and people that you're inspired and motivated by. And I definitely have all of those, but even my role models, like, I'm not trying to specifically be like them. I'm just trying to kind of play the same role that they're playing and do the same thing that they're doing. So in my case, I make gaming videos on YouTube. I've been making Call of Duty videos for the past 3 years. And my role models, I guess, would be like people like CNanners, people like Hutch, Tabes, Zerg Grizz, Blame Truth, Only Use Me Blade. You know, people like this. Like, all those dudes that I just listed, those are all legends within the Call of Duty community. As far as the Call of Duty community goes, they're like the top of the top. Those guys are the cream of the crop. And I mean, I could list more, like Woody, X-Jaws, White Boy, but like the reason that people like Hutch and CNanners really stood out to me is that not only were they these new gameplay commentators, and they were really good at being entertaining on a microphone and talking over gameplay at the same time, which is what I wanted to do and which is what I started doing a few years ago. Not only that, but they were also just real people, and you could tell that these were just real dudes just like chilling and talking into microphones and trying to be entertaining and trying to entertain and inform the people of YouTube. And that's what I wanted to do, and it kind of helped me really dig deep into my personality and who I am as a person when I started seeing, you know, CNanners would open up into like philosophical sort of things. And Hutch especially, Hutch was just always really open with his personal life. Like, two, maybe three plus years ago now, he would talk about like his girlfriend from back in the day, and he would do dual commentaries with her, and that's like one of the main inspirations for why I started doing commentaries with my girlfriend. I saw Hutch and Julia, And I was like, man, I need to get Taylor in on some commentaries. And this is when Taylor had only been dating me for like a year. Now we've been dating over 4 years, and it's crazy. We're still going strong. We're still in a really good relationship, and we still make videos together every now and then. But it's just, man, this whole experience has been so weird. Like, I don't really know how to explain how I became some sort of a thing, like how I became Muzza Fuzza within this community, and how some people sort of look up to me, and people watch all my videos and stuff like this, and I have like a developed fan base of at least a few thousand hardcore fans, and when I'm getting, you know, really popular videos on really popular topics, or popular new games, or whatever it is, or if I'm doing guides or tips and tricks, I can reach hundreds of thousands, even sometimes millions of people, and that's just like so awesome to me that I can do this all from the comfort of my own home. I don't have to like go out and network and meet a bunch of people. Like, I can do all this just from the safe little bubble of my computer. And if you think of me as some sort of a role model, like I'm a cool guy. Oh, look at that. Yeah, I'm a very cool guy getting the triple feed with the collateral. Oh, that little bitch was in Second Chance or Last Stand, Final Stand, whatever it's called in this game. I don't really play Modern Warfare 3 anymore at all, so I can't even remember what that stupid death streak is called. I think it's probably Final Stand. I am so happy that there's going to be no death streaks in Black Ops 2, you guys. You have no idea how happy I am. I'm just bursting with joy right now. But what I was trying to say is, like, it's good to have role models, it's good to have people that you look up to, but you shouldn't base your existence off of anyone else. You should definitely, I recommend this to everybody, all my friends, all my family, anybody. Like, you gotta be your own person. You gotta develop you. You gotta come up with your own ideas. You gotta be original. You gotta innovate and grow organically. You can't just grow off of someone else. You can't just be only, you know, famous or whatever you wanna call it, known. A lot of people in the Call of Duty community say known when they're arguing about how many subscribers they have. They say stuff like, get known, you random, get known, bad kid, stuff like that, just stupid, immature bullshit. And you can't be known just by association with other people. Nobody is famous for being Muzza Fuzza's friend, you know, like nobody is, it's just weird. It's such a weird situation for me to be in a position to be a role model. And a lot of people have left comments on some of my more profane and some of my more vulgar videos where I'm really, like, saying some ridiculous, outlandish shit. Like, I'll just say random, really, really crazy stuff just for the effect, you know? Sometimes I'll just get crazy. And some people take it well and like it and find it entertaining, and other people just find it either offensive or, you know, say things like you're a bad role model, you know that there's lots of little kids watching your videos. And I know that, like, the majority of my audience, I'm guessing the majority of you guys watching right now are fairly young. I'm saying, like, 15, 16, 17, sometimes, you know, 12, 13, 14. But at the same time, I know I also have a lot of fans that are older, that are adults, that can handle me saying fuck and shit and all that good, wonderful stuff that you can hear on cable television just by turning on your TV and flipping to Comedy Central or anything else. It's just weird for me to kind of draw a line and try to be a positive role model and try to be somebody that people would look up to. And I guess it's just helping me kind of work on my own image and work on how I want to be portrayed and how I want people to think of me, you know. But people just got to kind of take me as me. And if I decide to say some crazy shit, you just got to deal with it. There's nothing else you can do. Like, I'm not just going to go and delete the video. I'm not going to go and change my personality and change the way I act just to fit in some sort of a role model bubble. And I think I am a good person. Like, I know I believe in myself enough, and I have a good enough self-esteem and self-confidence that I know I'm a good person. I know I'm a cool dude. I know that I'm nice to people, and I know that I'm a lovely person, especially in the bed, you know, in the no-no zones. I'm all about that lovin's. But it was only until recently that somebody had actually, like, popped it into my head that, hey, you should probably work on being a role model for them kids. And I'm like, man, you're right. There are some kids that look up to me, and it would be really bad if I just start creating all these little punk assholes that think it's okay to go troll people and say whatever they want and do whatever they want. Like, I'm a fairly different person on the internet than I am in real life. Like, I'm totally all for trolling and having fun and joking all the time and just getting crazy. on the internet and on my video games, because I know there's not really any major repercussions. But if you see me in real life, I'm not going to be like crazy. I'm not going to be an obnoxious asshole. I'm just a very chill dude that likes to do all the things that normal people like to do. I like to hang out with friends, family. I like to go out. I like to go to movies. I like to listen to music. I like to go to parties. And I don't know, just my thoughts. Somebody told me to do a commentary about role models, so I did. If you guys have any other subjects or things, topics that you guys want me to cover in some commentaries, leave them down in the comments below. This has been Muzzafuzza. Thank you for watching, and I will see you later.